This is the second part of the story of our Prime Minister's war conference in the New World. Following his stirring speech to Congress in Washington, Mr. Churchill attended the Senate and House of Commons in Ottawa. He was welcomed there by a Canadian Guard of Honor. Mr. Churchill was introduced by Prime Minister MacKenzie King and received a tremendous ovation from the combined houses of Canada's government.
We have been concerting the united pacts and resolves of more than 30 states and nations to fight on in unity together and in fidelity, one with another, without any thought except the total and final extirpation of the Hitler tyranny, of the Japanese frenzy, and the Mussolini flop.
As a fitting tribute to French Canadians, Mr. Churchill also spoke in French.
Devoir, Dieu, sa place dans la grande compagnie des nations libératrices et victorieuses. The peoples of the British Empire may love peace. They do not seek the lands or wealth of any country. But they are a tough and hardy lot. We have not journeyed all this way across the centuries, across the oceans, across the mountains, across the prairies, because we are made of sugar candy. Look at the Londoners, the Cockneys. Look what they stood up to, grim and gay, with their cry, "We can take it," and their wartime mood, "What's good enough for anybody, good enough for us." We have not asked that the rules of the game should be modified. If any, we shall never descend to the German and Japanese level. But if anybody likes to play rough, we can play rough, too.
The Premier then referred to a discussion with the French government before the fall of France.
When I warned them that Britain would fight on alone, whatever they did, their general told their Prime Minister and his divided cabinet, "In 3 weeks, England will have her neck wrung like a chicken." Some chicken. Some neck.